So, in this particular lecture,
we are going to talk about vector integration. Clear? Vector integration. In the last lecture, we had completed till curl, I guess. Divergence and curl. So, in this lecture, we will talk about vector integration. So, there are three types of vector integration. You have line integral. You have line integral, which is, you know, actually a 1D plane concept. Then you have surface integral, which is a 2D plane concept. And you have the volume integral, which is considerably a 3D concept. Clear? Now, what do I mean by concept? Basically, you know, the plane in which the line integral is calculated is a 1D plane. Okay, is a 1D plane. So it can be the x axis or the y axis or the z axis or along a line, along a curve. Clear? You know, the surface integral is calculated along a 2D plane because it is calculated along a surface. Clear? A 2D surface. And this is calculated of a volume. Clear? And volume is 3D. Got it? Now, surface and volume integration will require concepts of multiple integration. So, I will also show some concepts of multiple integration in this video itself. In this lecture, we will cover line integral and surface integral. Volume integral we will be covering in the next video. Clear? Okay. So, now let us understand what is line integration. So, it is an integral which is evaluated along a curve. Very simply, only that much. Okay. So suppose you have a curve, say you have a curve C. Okay, C is a curve you have, and you know, suppose this is a curve C, and these are two points A and B on the curve itself, because we are calculating it along a curve actually. Clear? Acha. You have R equals to X I cap plus Y J cap plus Z K cap. So from here you get dr vector is equals to dx I cap plus dy j cap plus dz k cap. Now, you know, you can assume this curve to be a vector which has a particular direction. So the integration of this particular vector from A to B is given as the line integral. Let that be I. Line integral from A to B, f dot dr. Clear? F dot dr. Got it? So now what happens is that, you know, now if you have your f vector is equals to f1 I cap plus f2 j cap plus f3 k cap, then basically your integration, since it is a dot or dot operator, so basically it gives you scalar multiplication. So your I actually becomes integration A to B. So A, B are coordinates on the curve. Clear? So integration A to B, this becomes F1 dx plus F2 dy plus F3 dz. That is your final answer for the line integral. For example, you know, if you have basically, say, you have your F vector as force. You have your F vector as force. Then I will be giving you work done. Work done by the force along the curve. Along the curve from A to B, or let it be total work done. Okay, total work done by the force along the curve from A to B. Clear? Okay, sometimes what can happen, you know, you can be given this F1, F2 and F3 in parametric form. Clear? You can have F1 is equal to some psi t, F2 is equals to some, you know, psi t is basically suppose this is alpha t, your f3 is, you know, gamma t, let's say. So how can you basically, you know, solve these parts? So basically, you know, so f1 dx, basically, you know, you can change it rather. So basically your f1 dx integration, so say, so now you need to integrate f1 with respect to t, I guess, here. So you cannot anymore, you know, this integrate with this with respect to x. So you know, you will also you can also substitute x as some function of t. Okay, you can substitute, say, x equals to you can substitute x as some function of t. So this becomes xt, this becomes yt, and this becomes zt. And you know, then when you will be calculating dx, the dx will come in terms of dt. Clear? And then the multiplication, and after that the integration will be possible enough. Are you getting my point? Clear? Okay. So let's check a problem to solve to understand line integral concepts. Then it will be more clear to us, I guess. Suppose we have your f vector given as 3xy I cap minus y square j cap. Got it? And we are to calculate integral fdr along the curve C, where C gives you the equation y equals to 2x square in the xy plane, in the xy plane from 0, 0 to 1, 2. So how to solve this problem? So first thing first, you know, you have here basically integration 0, 0 to 1, 2, 3xy dx plus integration 0, 0, 1, 2. We are separating the integrations. Clear? Oh, so here will be minus. Minus. And here you have y square dy. Now this integration is quite easy to do, because you have y square, you also have your differential coefficient as, sorry, integral coefficient as dy, and the, you know, and you have your range in y coordinates also. But the problem lies in the dx integration, right? So what we will be doing here is that it is very simple. We will replace y with the value of x which is given along the curve. So we will replace y with 2x square. Now, if, now see this integration, what will give you? So this will give you basically y cube over 3. What are the y ranges? So the y range is from 0 to 2. So from 0 to 2. And what happens to this integration? So this basically becomes 6x cube. Okay, so 6x cube basically becomes, and here you have x to the power 4 over 4. Okay, and this ranges from 0 to 1. So basically this gives you 6 over 4 minus this gives you 8 over 3. Clear? This gives you 8 over 3. So this basically gives you minus 7 over 6. That is your line integral. Clear? I guess it's clear. Okay. We will also check some parametric form concepts. Okay. Let us check this parametric form concept. Okay. So let me get the question first. Okay, so the question is given pretty easily. Wait a minute. So, okay. So, let's start with the problem. I've got the question. So the question, okay, let me change the pane. So the question says that now here you have the parametric form of the R vector, clear? Generally you will be given the parametric form of the R vector only, because using the R vector you can form the parametric form of the curve itself. So it is not mandatory that every time you will be given a parametric form of the F vector. So given that if F vector is equals to 2y I cap minus 2j cap plus xk cap, evaluate. Now this is not properly line integral, this is a bit changed. So integral along the curve C, this is along the curve C, F vector cross dr vector. Clear? F vector cross dr vector, where x equals to cos t, y equals to sin t, and z equals to 2 cos t. And the range you have been given is t equals to 0, t equals to 0 to t equals to pi over 2. This is the range you have been given. Clear? So how to solve this problem? So solving this problem is quite easy to do. So, you know, basically what we can do is, you have been given your R vector as simply, you know, this is xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap, and which is basically given as you have your cos t, sin t and 2 cos t. So this is cos t I cap plus sin t j cap plus 2 cos t k cap. So your dr, if you want to find the dr, so what will be the dr basically here? So you need to differentiate both the sides with respect to t actually. Getting my point? You need to differentiate both the sides with respect to t actually. So basically here you can, here your dr becomes equal to d cos t, d sin t and 2 times d cos t. Clear? Then what you need to do? You divide every side with dt. And then you will be getting your final answer. So that is the trick we will be using here. Getting it? Getting my point? See what is happening here. So see, if you change it to dr, so this becomes d cos t, very simple, plus d sin t plus 2d cos t. Now you can write each of these as d over dt cos t, d over dt cos t dt, then this dt dt will cancel out. Then you can write it as d over dt sin t dt plus d over dt sin t, and this becomes 2 sin. So this is minus sign, right? Okay, now let us not write this. So this becomes 2 cos t dt k cap. Okay. Now you can write this as minus sin t dt, minus sin t dt. This becomes plus cos t dt and j cap, sorry, this is I cap, and minus 2 sin t dt k cap. Now clear? The step is clear. So now we need to find the vector actually. Okay, so let us do one thing. Let us now not, you know, get involved into the complexity of writing all these functions as dt dt dt. We now for this moment we consider dr equals to xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. Clear? So then what we can do is that, so basically, so this is your I cap, j cap, k cap. Okay, and so basically your F is, so let it be F1 I cap, F2 J cap, F3 K cap, and in the bottom you have DX, DY and DT for this moment. Okay, so DX, DY and DZ. We will be replacing it later on. So DX is nothing but cos T DT. Got it? Your DX is nothing but cos T DT. Sorry, minus sin T DT. Not cos T DT, minus sin theta dt. Okay. So by cross multiplication, you can find the integration. Let the integration be I. So the integration actually becomes along the curve C. So this becomes f2 dz minus f3 dy. Clear? Okay. Minus you have f1 dz. Okay, this is i cap. F1 dz minus f3 dx j cap plus you have f1 dy minus f2 dx k cap. Clear? Got it? Now we will be changing it into the parametric forms. So here you have the integration from 0 to pi over 2. What is your f2? So your f2 is basically given as minus z. Okay, your f2 is basically given as minus z. And what was your value of z? So your value of z was 2 cos t. Clear? So basically, so what does this become? So this becomes minus 2 cos t. And what was your dz? What was your dz? Your dz was minus 2 sin t. So basically this becomes actually plus. And here you have a 2 sin t dt. Clear? I cap. Minus. You have your f1 as 2y. What is your y? Your y is sin t. So you have your 2 sin t. And with 2 sin t you have dz. Clear? 2 sin t of dz. What was dz? Dz was minus 2 sin t. So this becomes minus 2 sin t. Minus 2 sin t. Clear? So wait a minute. So this becomes minus 2 sin t dt. Clear? Clear? And along with what you have is, oh, I have missed one thing. I have not written the f3 dy portion. I'm so sorry. Achha, so this is plus 2 cos t plus 2 sin t. Okay. And minus you have f3 dy. What is your f3? Your f3 is given as x. What was x? X was cos t. Okay. And you have dy here. So what was dy? Dy is your cos t dt. Right. Dy is your cos t dt. And your f3 was, sorry, I just forgot. What was your f3? F3 was x cos t. So basically this becomes cos square t. Cos square t dt. Now clear? This much I cap. Clear? This much I cap. Similarly, you have integration. I am separating the integrals. This is pi over 2. So this basically becomes minus 4 sin square t dt. Plus you will be having cos t sin t dt. Cos t sin t dt. This is under your j cap. And then you will be having plus integration 0 to pi over 2, 2 sin t cos t dt minus again you will be having 2 cos t sin t dt. So these two portions will eventually cancel out and you will have basically no k cap portion. Clear? Because this was under k cap. This was under your k cap. Okay, so this becomes 0. Clear? Now the problems are very much easy to find. So basically the integral got changed to, wait a minute. So this becomes 0 to, my stylus is causing some problem, 0 to pi over 2. Okay, so this is 4 cos t. This is 4 cos t sin t dt. You can take either cos t, you substitute either cos t with z or sin t with z. Both will give you correct answers. And minus here you add cos square t. So we will be changing cos square t into 1 plus cos 2 t over 2. So that we can easily integrate this. this has dt under I cap minus we have integration 0 to pi over 2, and you have a 2 times, so you have 1 minus cos 2t minus half sin 2t dt. Now here you have j cap. Okay, so now you can integrate this yourself to get your final answer. I have already solved this problem, so I have the answer itself. So I am leaving the question from here itself, and you can directly solve it from here. Each and every integration is quite simple from this part. You can substitute either cos t with z or sin t with z here. This one is very much easy to solve. Here you also have sin 2t multiple angle. Here you also have multiple angle. Here you also have multiple angle. So every portion is easy to solve now. Okay. So in the next part, we will be talking about double integration, guys. Correct?